Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness is directed by Sam Raimi and is his first time in the director's chair in 10 years. This new Marvel entry follows Doctor Strange, with the help of mystical allies, both old and new, traverses the mind-bending and dangerous alternate realities of the multiverse to confront a mysterious new adversary. I'm Jacob, and I just watched this movie. I was interested to see this film, Sam Raimi being a favorite of mine, and this is his first film in a while. I was curious if this would deliver as a Sam Raimi film. Then the film released and there was a mixed reaction from fans online. There was a bunch of people that don't like it at all, saying it's too violent and more of a Raimi movie. And then the Raimi fans were loving it, saying it's a new return to the superhero genre with the blood of Evil Dead running through in full form. After finally watching this film, I can say that it's enjoyable and it did feel a little different than most Marvel films. And the argument of is this more of a Raimi movie or not, I think it falls somewhere in the middle. His stamp is for sure on it, but it is still very much a Marvel film. To start with my positives, I'll say that the action sequences were great in this film, and overall I'd say the first half was really strong. The film starts a lot faster than I thought it would, and I was in it. I enjoyed what was being set up. Scarlet Witch was a great villain, and her presence throughout the entirety was great. In the first half, there's this battle with her and all the sorcerers, and it was great. And it sets up how brutal her character will be in the film. Back onto the character of Doctor Strange, I think that overall, as a Doctor Strange film, I thought this was a much better film than the first. The first one had some cool elements, but was overall not memorable in the slightest. This film definitely had some really cool visuals and a lot of great moments that were awesome to see in a Marvel film. I don't want to give away everything that happens, but this film really made me excited to see further adventures and stuff with this character and these kinds of powers. There's the fight where they are lifting music notes and fighting with the music. Visually and everything, I thought that was awesome. It's in the trailer, there's Doctor Strange as a zombie making wings out of demons. Was such a comic book idea and just one of the greatest visuals we've gotten in a Marvel film. This leads me to some of my issues with the film, and some are just kind of issues I'm having with the Marvel formula. Some of what I talk about here might be spoilers, so if you want to skip ahead, there's your warning. The demon wing Doctor Strange is awesome, but it comes in at the end, and it's about the same thing as the dragon in Shang-Chi. It's a cool, expensive visual, and like a power-up that the hero will get right at the end. It's on screen for like a minute, and then it just disappears. My issue isn't necessarily, hey, I want more cool stuff. It's more that it just feels like they figured out the beat. They know, okay, we need this moment in the final where the hero figures out something about themselves and gains more power, but it's just done for the sake of doing it. It's a visual that's there, so hey, they can say they did it, but it's not an element of the film or something that gets really used or put to some extended use in the film. It's there because we need this moment to move to the next. My other issue with the film is something that I'm not sure I'm really negative on, but to me, watching this film, it was the same feeling I got watching Oz the Great and Powerful, which is Sam Raimi, really likes shooting the Wicked Witch. In both of these films, the witch is just way more interesting and shot in a cool way. Again, it isn't necessarily an issue, but Scarlet Witch just comes off as a more interesting character than Doctor Strange does in a Doctor Strange film. My final negative is that this film marks a point in the MCU where it's no longer based off of plot lines of just the films, but now also the TV shows, with WandaVision being a big part of this. Now, I never watched all of WandaVision. I saw a couple of episodes and I get the idea enough, but it just seems too far. There are already so many Marvel films to stay caught up on. I'm not sure how interested I'm going to stay in the MCU if watching four miniseries a year along with four films are required to get the full story.
You're wondering what happens now.
Overall, I thought that this was a good movie. Sam Raimi can still make a good superhero film and deliver on his kind of tone and manages to slip a whole lot of references to the Evil Dead trilogy in there too. This film is still very much an MCU film and has all the baggage that comes with that. This was a creative entry and it did surprise me a couple of times, so I'm giving Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness a 7 out of 10.
Yeah!
So if you saw this movie, leave your thoughts in the comments down below and don't forget to like and subscribe.